The question for Senator Sullivan and the other senators for counsel for President. Given that the Senate is now considering the very evidentiary record assembled and voted on by the House, which Chairman Nadler has repeatedly claimed constitutes overwhelming evidence for impeachment, how can the Senate be accused of engaging in what Mr. Nadler described as a cover-up if the Senate makes its decision based on the exact same evidentiary record the House did?
Mr. Chief Justice, Senators, thank you for that question, and I think that's exactly right. I think it's rather preposterous to suggest that this Senate would be engaging in a cover-up to rely on the same record that the House managers have said is overwhelming. They've said it dozens of times. They've said that, in their view, they've had enough evidence presented already to establish their case beyond any doubt, not just beyond a reasonable doubt. And it's totally incoherent to claim at the same time that it would be improper for the Senate to rely on that record. Your judgment may be and should be, we submit, different from the House manager's assessment of that evidence because it hasn't established their case at all. But if they're willing to tell you that it's complete and it has everything they need to establish everything they want, I think you should be able to take them at their word that that's all that's there. And the switch now to say, well, no, we need more witnesses, I think just demonstrates that they haven't proved their case. They don't have the evidence to make their case. And as I went through a minute ago, you know, they have already presented a record with over 28,000 pages of documents that's here. They've already presented video clips of 13 witnesses. You've heard all of the key evidence that they gathered. It was their process. They were the ones that said what the process was going to be, how it had to be run, who ought to testify, and when to close it, when to decide they had enough. And you've heard all of the key highlights from that. And that is sufficient for this body to make a decision. If in the time I have remaining, I just want to turn to one point in response to something that was said a couple of minutes ago, and we keep hearing repeatedly today the refrain of the idea that President Trump was somehow trying to peddle Vladimir Putin's conspiracy theory, that it was Ukraine and not Russia that interfered in the 2016 election. And the House Democrats try to present this binary view of the world, that only one country and one country alone could have done something to interfere in the election, and it was Russia. And if you mention any other country doing something related to election interference, you're just a pawn of Vladimir Putin trying to peddle his conspiracy theories. That is obviously not true. More than one country and foreign nationals from more than one country could be doing different things for different reasons in different ways to try to interfere in the election. And that's exactly what President Trump was interested in. In the telephone call, the July 25th transcript, he mentions CrowdStrike, he mentions the server, but he talks about, he says, there are a lot of things that went on, the whole situation. I think you're surrounding yourself with some of the same people. So he's talking about much more than just the DNC server. And he closes it again saying, he refers to Robert Mueller's testimony. And he says, they say a lot of it started in Ukraine. There's just a lot of stuff going on. Twice in that exchange, he says, there's a lot of stuff, the whole situation. And what is that referring to? Surrounding yourself with the same people, President Zelensky refers immediately to changing out the ambassador. Because the previous ambassador, who had been there under Poroshenko, had written an op-ed criticizing President Trump during the election. We also know that there was a Politico article in January of 2017 cataloging multiple Ukrainian officials who did things either to criticize President Trump or to assist a DNC operative, Alexandra Chalupa, in gathering information against the Trump campaign. And they said there was no evidence in the record. No one said that there was anything done by Ukraine. That's not true. One of their star witnesses, Fiona Hill, specifically testified in her public hearing, because she said she went back and checked because she hadn't remembered the political article. And then she said that she acknowledged that some Ukrainian officials, quote, bet on Hillary Clinton winning the election, end quote. And so it was quite evident, in her words, that they were trying to favor the Clinton campaign, including by trying to collect information on people working in the Trump campaign. That was Fiona Hill. She acknowledged that Ukrainian officials were doing that. So this idea that it's a binary world, it's either Russia or Ukraine, if you mention Ukraine, you're just doing Vladimir Putin's bidding, is totally false. And you shouldn't be fooled by that. The Ukrainians, various Ukrainians, were doing things to interfere in the election campaign, and that's what President Trump was referring to.